Good morning, Benny Jeef here from Aussie Abroad. As you can see, it's pretty fucking early in the morning. It's about 4:10 in the morning. I'm heading to the train station. We're going to London. Going to London. We are going to the World Championships, boys and girls. Really looking forward to it. Yes, it's the Darts World Championships. PGC World Darts Championships at the Ali Pali. Gonna be there. Got a really early flight. I'm only staying there for a day and a half. So, gonna make the most of it. I'm a little bit tired. Had to work last night. Doesn't matter. All good. No problem. Next time you see me, I'll be in London. See you guys. Bye. Officially in London, I'm fucking shattered. I'm gonna try and find my Airbnb, have a short rest. We're going straight to the Alexander Palace. Bah! Almost there, almost. Guys, at the Alexandra Palace inside. I just did a fantastic interview with some of the guys out the front from Channel 5. That means nothing to me, something in the UK. So if you're in the know, it's going to be aired sometime in January. They're doing a special about cultural appropriation and how that we are a society that is PC gone mad. So I thought it was quite interesting, actually, because they were asking me, what would you consider to be costumes that would be considered to be inappropriate? And it got to the point where it's like, you dressed up as a Nazi. Yes, absolutely. But dressing up as a priest or dressing up as a cardinal or anything like that is just a lot of fun. And they're trying to get these PC warriors out of the picture. It's a little bit crazy to me, because there is actually a university here in England that is trying to ban fancy dress in the darts, which is crazy. So I'm in fancy dress. You look around me, there'll be a few other people in fancy dress, as you'll see, but I'll get them on camera later. Just thought I'd like to add that little tidbit, and yeah, I'm gonna be on TV. Calm before the storm, guys, here at the Alexander Palace, waiting for the darts to start. This is what my view is like. It's gonna be fun. The only thing is, there's no one sitting next to me. I hope there's someone that comes to sit next to me, so we can enjoy the festivities together. I want to make some friends and Yeah, I'll let you know later on. When things get going, it's gonna be good. Fucking better turn up tonight. This, I put a bet on for some random guys I just met, and I said that you're gonna win that one, 3-1, easy bet. You better win. If you don't, you're in trouble because you didn't get me VIP tickets. James Bailey for the win.
Guys, so as you can see here, I'm having a pretty good time. The darts was amazing. I think I've had one too many beers, but I thought I'd just take a time out after I've made those comments to James Bailey that we kept in contact, and he ended up calling me and telling me that he did have a VIP spot for me. And so I was heading out with some friends that I met at the venue, and when I got the call, so I came back and I went back to the VIP area, and when I went back to the VIP area, there was some troubles at the door, but they finally let me in. I said, I'm here to see James Bailey. He's a friend of mine from Australia, and so the guy led me back to the players room. And when I got to the players' room, everything was great. I was waiting for James. He was just out onto the on the stage, just having a look at how everything is, and had a few throws on the board. Then he came back in. Everything was fine. We had a little chat. I spoke to one of the juniors that represented Australia for the World Youth. I think he got to the last 32. Good young guy, actually. Spoke to his father and I said that he's got a lot of potential. Anyways, James, cutting to the chase, James was about to go up and play in the next half an hour or so. So, when it came down to it, James kind of disappeared. And I was like, what's going on here? So I spoke to security, and I said, "Oh, look, can I go out and see James play?" I don't know how this came across. Maybe I was slowing my words or something. But long story short, they gave me the rundown and said that, "Oh, we've been watching you. You've had too many to drink, and you're not allowed to go into the VIP section." So what happens from there? Things get a little bit awkward. I'm, needless to say, I'm a little bit pissed off. And They've given me an ultimatum. They said, you can either watch the game in the players' room or you can leave, but you won't be able to come back in. You'll have to give your wristband in and you'll just have to go out. And I've gone out onto the street outside the Alexander Palace. I've lost my players' room privileges, lost an opportunity to speak to some of the players. I'm not sure if I'm too upset about that, but because I've met some of these guys before. Dimitri Vandenberg, still in the tournament, really good friend of mine. Mate, you're doing fantastic. I guess I can take this time to say sorry I didn't stick around, James. I was a little bit upset with the situation, but I hope you understand. I'm really sorry that you actually lost your match. But that's the way it goes. Don't want to go too much on that. I just sort of do a little story time on what actually happened after that those moments. It actually started raining after that, which was a pain in the ass. So I had to actually go out, and I actually got lost trying to find my Airbnb. So that's kind of sucked. But that's the way it goes. So if anyone's wondering what happened to me, especially you, James, yeah, that's kind of what the deal was. And I was a little bit pissed off with the security because I think I felt like I behaved in a fairly well-mannered way. So
So I'm in here in the players' room. Gotta be on my best behaviour. So I'm waiting for James to come back. I'm here.
It is what it is. I thought I'd just let everyone know what was going on, and we'll get back to the video. Get on to day two. Enjoy.
Good morning, everyone. It's day two of my little adventure in London, going to the World Championships. As you can see, I'm a hipster today, hippieing it up. It's quite a nice day, to be honest. Although it's nice, I'm still a little bit tipsy from yesterday. It was a quite a messy one. I got a few stories to tell you. Actually, I'll tell you now. I'll tell you. So yesterday, James Bailey was able to get me into the players area, and after he got me into the players area, I've had too many to drink, and there has been a they told me I couldn't go into the main hall to watch the darts. So I got into the players area, but I couldn't get into the VIP section. It was a bit of a bummer, and I sort of just left in a huff. James unfortunately lost anyways. So the Heart of Australia's on Simon Whitlock and Kyle Anderson's shoulders. We're expecting a lot from you boys. So let's bring home the trophy. But yeah, apart from that, last night was fun. The only disappointment was me having to go home early after not being allowed into the VIP section. So yeah, they're pretty strict on the intoxication laws. Not laws here, just expectations of the people in the VIP. So it serves me right for drinking too much. Maybe what the equivalent of about 8 to 10 pints of beer. Anyways, I won't be doing that again today. I got a plane to catch tonight, so I'm just gonna be taking it easy. And yeah, bring on day two. Let's go.
There's a wind blowing in old London town today. It's not brought in Mary Poppins. It's brought in the hurricane, Kim Hybrex. He's got the dangerous Daniel Martin in the second round.
Yeah! Flow Hybrex is going to win this one in straight sets. He's two sets up, two legs up. Doesn't look good.